Okay, so it's the 13th of February. I'm watching the games of the 11th of February, where you played flex games. First off, let's look at team composition. Lucian Thresh, I think, is a really strong lane. They are up against Ashe, Nami, which they should be able to all in. Nami can heal up and Ashe can poke better than Lucian and Thresh can, so yeah, all-ins are winnable, but it's kind of dangerous to get outpoked. Ahri versus Talon. Talon has skill pressure on the Ahri, especially with Ignite and Ultimate, but Ahri is better at pushing the wave. And trying to make sure that Talon cannot roam. If the wave management is solid, Talon is in a tough spot to do anything and impact the game. But Ahri has a mana bar, so she cannot do it continuously, and there are times where she needs to back off to get items and mana back, while and those are the opportunities for Talon. So she can call those out. Jungle, Sejuani, really solid against Camille. Camille is always scary level 2 because of the E. Those early ganks are really devastating. But Sejuani can outskill and potentially get better team fights. And is also able to gank really well, just as a little bit later. Top lane, Rumble versus Teemo. Of course, I don't know the matchup itself, but Rumble is a solid pick for the ultimate. And I think that's winnable. But I don't know Teemo. Let's see here. Okay, you seem to be going for an invade. It's, yeah, and it's doable with Thresh. It's good to scrape this. And then walk here. Okay. The hook lands. And you get a flash. Nice. Okay, so now you all walk back. But you got this position. And you could place a ward here a little bit later to know where the enemy jungler is at. So the invade is good. Walking here, hooking and getting the flash. Really good. But you can leave a ward in here to get a little bit more information. Wards here, here, good. So early on, Talon is pushing, which causes him to have priority. Let's see, discover, yeah. So because Camille is really quick, let's see if she got, yeah, she even got two camps. Yeah, so Camille is way faster early, so then it's better to just give up this Skittle and go from red to Raptors. To topside Skittle. Let's see if you could see that before. Oh, she even smited it, but you can. Okay, so if. Now, if you place the ward, it would have expired by now. So for the jungler, you know she started bot side. That's the information you know. Bot lane is kind of even, and mid lane you don't have priority. So taking the Skittle is, yeah, it would be dangerous even if Camille isn't here. So it's better to just loop around and try to get this one, and then clear your top side. So give this up, that's fine. Talon backs off because he knows you're here, and you go to this one. So now you achieve the same thing of getting the Skittle. It just So it just took a little longer, and they know you're there. That's the difference. Okay. So Talon, yeah. Talon just has a lot of damage. Let's see how this happened. From level 1. So level 1, you don't need to be afraid of him yet, because of your range autos. And here he can hit the minions and you. Which I talked about a little bit earlier. If someone can hit the minions for the wave clear and the champion, that's a lot of value out of his ability. Which you can try to avoid while... on the other hand, you also want to hit your Q on the minions and on him. So... yeah, this W only hits you and not the minions. Yeah, it hit like one minion. So that's already better. It forces him to make a decision hitting you or hitting minions. And your Q hits him, so that's good. This minion makes a level 2. And yeah, that W again hits you and the minions. So try to know his W width to dodge it. Yeah, he's looking for the W's. See, he has Q and W. Okay, this is walking up a lot. I know Sejuani is here, but I don't know if you communicated something. If Sejuani isn't here, he can kill you. But since Sejuani is here, he cannot right now. And because Sejuani is further away now, if you do this again, he jumps on you. And he can kill you with Q, W, Ignite, Passive, etc. So he played this lane really well. How you can avoid this is... you also know Camille is close, since the jungler interacted with him. So you need to give up a little bit more. Yeah. At these early levels, you have to stay out of his Q range. Can you see it? No, you can't see the Q range. But this is just what Talon does. I think Talon played this really well with his W's. He seems to know his champions. That's unlucky. Camille is walking to Skuttle. Okay, Skuttle is walking this way now. But top lane, it's kind of even, but your Rumble is closer to you than Teemo. So what you can do is... staying on this side of the Skuttle, so that he moves upwards. And here, you walk a little bit to the left, which causes the Skuttle to walk back, and Camille is coming. And she steals it. So that's unlucky, but it could be defended if Skuttle was here. And then you would have just walked out when Camille came. And again, if you walked immediately before contesting this one, you would have also had it before Camille would come. Because you see Rumble is coming, and while Teemo was still here. So that's looking at the priorities in lane, which I talked about immediately. Top lane, bot lane does not really have priority since the Ash has W to again hit minions and champion. Talon has priority because of W early on, and the mana costs are really low, and but your Wumble has priority, so play around the Wumble early before you are trying to gank. Okay, your Q is up. I think here you can try to hook Nami. Wait, why don't you have W? Okay, yours as Lucian, because of mana flow band, you start W now. Then E, then Q. But that's a minor thing. But Thresh, I think you can try to hook here. since she's walking up to try to punish Lucien, but your hook is up now. You can try to punish more, and yeah, the auto is yeah, it's something, but I think if you Q, then Lucien can auto E, auto auto Q, auto auto, and then Nami's almost dead. So that's the all-ins you're looking for. It's good that you lay back because of the poke, try to stay behind minions, but if you see the opportunity, you shouldn't be afraid to pull the trigger and go for it. You have the kill lane, you have the Lucien. You should use his back. That's a poke. Okay, there's some action coming up, bot lane. Walking up behind minions to attack her, it's possible. Here you go for the hook, but there she was a little bit too far away. So yeah, here she's behind minions, so you can't hook. And this is too far away. You are all the way back here, which causes her to just be able to walk away while hitting Lucien. You can stay close or walk a little bit more up. Walk up a little bit more, since Ashe, there were minions behind, between Ashe and you. Yeah, see? The HW doesn't hit you because of the minions, that's really good. Ashe is greedy. Yeah, see? This is exactly what I meant when the Nami walked up. If they walk up, you just punish them, that's really good. I just think that you could have done this earlier, but this hook, really good. So Lucien dashes, bam, even uses W, flashes forward, nice, a very nice kill. You got the kill first, but Ignite kills you, bam. Yeah, overall play was good, good hook, it's just unlucky that Ignite still killed you. I think you, you can just heal earlier, but you know this is a full-on engage. You can just heal here, just in case. If they heal and you know, okay, it's I need to flash in, it's dangerous. You can heal so the Ignite doesn't get the grievous wounds, and then you would have lived. But it's like... Of course it's better if you look at it in hindsight, but before it's like, why should I heal and not in danger of dying? But heal has like a short cooldown, you only use it in full engages, so... You can just heal it, I'm also trying to do it myself, but I'm also kind of greedy, so... So the jungler, after backing... Yeah, you just want to get this camp and this one, then loop for mid or something. Maybe even just get this and then mid already, but you're walking all the way bot. So you're planning a gank bot, that's possible, but since Ashe gives the opportunity to the bot lane themselves, they already make the play. And then you see this hook, yeah, you can say, okay, I'll walk to you. But when Ashe is dead, okay, you just back off to the camp. Because this is like 10, 15 seconds where you do nothing and you even show yourself on the ward so the enemy knows where you are. So Camille's got already. That's good padding by her. She's... So she has priority mid lane, but she takes a skull top, so now she's spotted by Rumble and you know where she is, and that's bad by her. She should have taken the skull to mid lane. Where is she going? Wait, how is she full mana? Okay. Skuller gives half mana back. So you know that Camillus is in the river. So gank your mid is really dangerous. Talon even hit six. So if you gank, you fucking die. Ignite, you just die. And you even know Camillus there, so that would be disastrous. Arkshot spots you. It's impossible the Arkshot spotted you. That's unfortunate. Let's see how the CSs are going. Yeah, Lucian has a nice lead on Ashe. It's really good. While mid is behind, but this is expected. So, bot lane, this CS advantage is good because Ashe has the poke, so the CS could be closer. And mid lane just has to give up some CS. Aoi is as useful as Talon if she has a little bit less gold. That's the thing with assassins. If you die to them, even once, but if you die to them more times than that, they become more useful in snowball. But if you're a little bit behind, you can still have the same relevancy as them, because they need the resources. It's not like they always get the resources because they had no, they need them. If a Zed walks out of lane 0-0 with the same CS as an Aoi, Orianna, etc., the mage is more useful. And that's something I think you need to understand. Jasmine, that some matchups are just not winnable, and it's fine if you're behind. This game is about the Rumble and the Lucian, and the Aoi is kind of a charm bot, and that's it. Okay, good use of the brush. They are standing really close. If you hook, you'll probably hit someone. Yeah, you decide to do that. Bump. Nice clipping. Okay, so the solution mechanic. Let's see what's on cooldown. So the hook hits here, so you can dash. Okay, or you dash earlier before the flame. To get the double shot off, but because the flay is really good, you can just auto once, then E, auto, then W, because W is a skill shot which is not guaranteed, auto, then Q, auto, because the passive, then you get more damage off, because now you E and you Q without doing an auto attack in between, which is kind of inefficient. You still manage to get the kill because Lucian is broken. But in other cases where maybe it's a Braum or someone who's quite tankier, then you can make more efficient use of your abilities and spacing them out in between. Yeah, you take some poke from Ash on the backside, but the play itself is good and it works out. So jungler, you're here. So here Talon leaves lane, because Talon, like I said before, if he pushes, then he can roam. There's no reason for him to roam bot, since bot lane just got the kill, he shouldn't be able to kill them. So you after wolves, you can park the dragon. So you know, okay, bot lane is dead, I'm gonna get dragon. It's an infernal, that's why the priority. If this was air or something, you just take romp and leave it. But since this is infernal, you can use the special bot lane gives you to get the dragon. So you just say bot lane, okay, push this wave in. I'm on my way to infernal. You don't have any information on Camille, but it's or it's Camille Ash versus you three, which you win, or she doesn't join and you get the infernal for free. Can I see how close you are to six though? Oh, I can't. It's unlucky. But Talon roams mid. It's getting assessed. I don't know if you called it earlier, but the thing is, if she pushes, like here he pushes because it's W, I think. Yeah, W. And then you see he leaves. Then you can immediately call it. And bot in is fine, because they were two. But I don't know if you called it in voice, but you can call it earlier. So instead of focusing on the waves, you can say, okay, he's missing. Yeah, Camilla's situation is really good. You are pushed quite far without a ward, but not too far, so you can still leave. But you walk back in. So I think, from what I see, the Talon is called. Kind of late, but still called. You hear it, you walk back. But you're a greedy son of a bitch, so you walk back in. And you get punished for it, really hard. You flash, but he flashes as well. And you die. You can just walk back. Like, the wave was coming, the... What are you achieving by walking back here? You can hit Teemo a little bit. But, like, if you walk up here and there's no Talon, Teemo just walks back. And gets this wave to stop this wave and starts yesing again. And forces you to overextend. So walking back here doesn't give you anything. So either you walk back until Talon is efficient again. Then you push, and then you ward. Or you just stay back, maybe take the vehicle or something. But you have to stay back until Talon shows again. If Talon doesn't achieve anything of this worm, this is really good. And if he kills you, that can make him able to snowball. Which he does. It doesn't matter that he uses Ignite and Flash. The only thing that matters for him is the gold. He'll probably text Teemo. So right now, so you're here, but there's nothing to gain. You are too late because Talon has so much burst. You are not 6 yet. It's better to just try to get a dragon. Or even Gromp is doing better than doing nothing. It's a comms mistake. And right now you are losing tempo because of that mistake. Build Sheldon, nice. Okay, so you bought both mobility, that's fine, but what are you gonna roam? You can roam. Teemo is being pushed in, so you can't really roam top lane. Mid lane, if you try to roam and you miss the hook, which of course can happen, Talon kills your Aoi or kills you, while you win bot lane. So I don't think boost mobility is good in this case. If they had a mage with low mobility and you had like an Ezreal or Caitlyn, someone self-sustainable, or Sivir, Xayah, then you can do this. But I don't think the boost mobility are really good in this game. It's good to look for worms, but right now the focus is on your lane and not on other lanes. You ult in. Yeah. This was ganking Talon is really hard because of the wall jumping ability. You can wait here, and Aoi can try to poke him, and if Talon jumps on her, because you know the ultimate is down, the ignite is down. If Talon jumps on her, then you can come with your own ultimate and CC him. And if he walks back here, then Aoi can ult for the charm because there are no walls. But since you come, you immediately use your dash, which puts it on cooldown. Or you just pause and then the cooldown is off. Bam, you can Q again. Sorry. So here you can look for the charm, since he's far away from the wall. Instead, you ult again. Then he jumps. And here you can immediately charm, because even if he jumps over the wall, you know it's a straight line. But you charm after he jumps, which causes you to... then you need to hit the blind charm, which is hard. If you charm here or here, Sejuani can follow with ultimate, smite, W, and then Talon is, I think, dead. But it still, again, needs to go. Ping your bot lane, danger. So you are going to a Talon alone. This is half of his HP. So, okay, so I know for certain if the charm hits, then he dies. You're going to fucking kill him? Sejuani, man, what a champion. I know he didn't have ultimate or ignite, but still, you're a fucking tank. Oh, okay. Nice hook. So, okay, I'm not gonna, you know, that mechanically that wasn't really well. But you still get two kills, ambitious play. But I don't think it was really neat. I think the Infernal is more important than the chance of getting kills, but, you know, it works. If it works, it works. Okay, Akam, you know, your, all your allies are bot side, trying to get kills, plays, and getting dragon. Without a Kabil showing. The Teemo is still back. And you have a ward here, but you know, if you think about it, the Rumble. If Camille shows here and walks here, hookshots, she's here before you are even here. So you know in your mind this ward doesn't make you safe. She's even walking the phone, she's even parting the wrong way. And just also, like, she parts the wrong way, Teemo doesn't follow, the E doesn't hit you. And still, she's able to run you down. And there's no reason to really walk up since your team is doing this wake and everything. It's best to just push and then fall back until you know where Camille is. Like if Camille shows here to contest Dragon, then you can try to kill Teemo. But before that, it's unnecessary. It's good of Camille to play the cross map and get some pressure there. Okay, Dragon is fine. Talon could have just killed Lucian. If you get Dragon, because you took the kills here, Dragon takes longer, which is fine. But it also means that Talon is back up, and he can kill you. If you push his tower. He goes mid, so that's lucky for you. But beware that it's better to back, since it's dangerous. And then you also have a faster back timing to make play bot again. Like if you come back to lane and call Sejuani for a gank and you kill them, then you get all the plates, you get the entire tower. Since you're so far ahead, it's not like you get a desperation 160 gold. You get the recurve bow. Yeah, okay, you also know. How much gold you have, you can get the entire base to run king, and you have 260 gold left. That's enough to get two pink wards. Yeah. With 160 less, you would have had 100 gold and just one pink ward. Which is already a really good back. So the risk is even more necessary. Okay, you get the pink. Yeah. So mid lane, because you're behind, you're unable to push. Which again is fine. He even has Hexwinkers, so making all in right now is even harder than before. So the focus is just CSing, clean the wave. This, yeah, there's no reason to walk up further than this, that's good. This is how you play the matchup when behind, just giving up. Losing two CS per wave is fine. You still have the charm, you still have the ultimate, which are not dependent on items. You go in, he ults. Okay. Okay, this is a really good play. Yeah. Nice. Tejani's coming. And yeah, you ult in him. And here he's, again, he's far away from walls. He ults. So he could have I don't think he can... I don't think he can jump this wall already. So it's good that you return ganked so so fast. He still jumps on you. I think it's good that you walk the other way. You're not in kill range for him. You ult away again. The Sejuani ult is really good. Good follow. Charm miss is unfortunate, but it doesn't matter, and you kill him. I think this play is just really good. Also, by Sigi to make the call to skip. I think he was at Scuttle, so it's good that you skip Scuttle to help mid lane. And then you can steal the Scuttle, because the vision here is really good. This pink was really good. This pink was really good. So this river is lit up for a potential Herald also. Botlane got ganked by Camille, and Camille wants to gank an Ashe that's way behind. They're pushing you in, which is logical because Lucian backed. Oh, that's also something, because you're backed late, they also have, can push the wave, and this makes you lose some CS, which is of course fine, but it makes the plate even less valuable. Good dash, bam bam. Q, bam bam. Flash. Let's look at the cooldowns. Your ultimate isn't up, so you know you're not gonna kill them entirely. Bam 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 bam. Okay, it's really good, but I don't think the flash is necessary into an Ashe, because your ult, yeah, it just wasn't up. This is over-aggression, because you don't know anything. Your wave is, yeah, it's here, just killing the minion still. You're an entire enemy wave, Nami bubble will be back up. Like, after you get Ashe's flash, I think you should just back off. And wait for Sigi to complete the play here. So the bubble comes, Camille flashes in. Shit, Iep. Okay, so this is not coordinated by them. They don't turn. When she hits the bubble, Ashe and Nami can just turn on you and kill you. So this is, yeah, this is their fault, but they should have punished you. When you walk up too far, you two should be dead and they should all be alive and maybe even take this entire third. So that's, I think, over aggression. Map is really good. Oh, wait. Like, they do the same. You queued earlier, and now your queue is back up. So when they walk for fucking 20 seconds or something, you can hook. Yeah, really, really good finish. Your flare, yeah, it's not in time range, but your igniter, and bam bam, she's dead. The play begins under your turret, where it's a really good dash play to get their, flash. Then you overextend on them. Almost die, but because they make mistakes, you kill them. Then you walk back, and then they overextend, and you kill them. That's like 40 seconds of just people overextending time and time again. Yeah, you kill her. Really good red clicks. And now you can freely push, since you know the Camille is down. You get boots already, because 1100 gold, this plate is... So now this plate is more valuable than it was before, because Inferno is already down and your jungler is looking to get Herald, so you need to take plates on your own. You cannot expect your jungler to be there within 2 minutes to get the tower, so now I think the plates are fine. But don't always greed for the plates. There are ways where backing faster and being in lane 10 seconds faster is more valuable than the gold. But this is time where the gold is fine. But this hitting, but this is too long. I think 2 plates were fast fine. The getting out was really good because there was vision everywhere. Yeah, you give it this vision for this, it's fine. So, you get held at 12 minute 40. Plates despawn at 40 minutes. So if you can make a play at mid lane to get this tower, that would be really good for the extra gold that Harold gives because the plates. And let's see what you do. Also, this is, since the boost of ability, I think this is the first roam you did. Which that's why I was skeptical about the boost of ability. He jumps. Okay, you cancel the wall jump. He flashes to jump that wall. You can, yeah, you can try to flay early, but that's really hard. Give up on the play since you don't have support. And he may kill you. Okay, so Sejuani ult comes. Ooh, that ult is dangerous. Okay, you get him. Nice. Okay, weird flex. Please help. Okay, so here is the place herald for the turret. This is okay, so this has 4 plates left. Which is 640 gold above the first tower bonus. That's a lot. That's almost half an item, it's like almost 1000 gold. You can place the herald and then back off. Okay, you don't. So let's see where you place the herald later. Botting comes back into lane. You don't know anything. Okay, unlucky you didn't get an army, but this is over aggression. It's unlucky that W didn't hit, but. But this play almost. This almost worked because you're so far ahead. But Lucian Wayne's ult is like until here. So you don't need to walk up on her. You can walk back. Then an extra, yeah, an extra shot hits, but this is unlucky. After the wave, yeah, you can W, but and then E back immediately. Instead, it takes a while. You eat too late and you get punished. Like she dies to minions. That's, yeah, also it goes. But you don't have vision here, you haven't seen Camille in a while, your jungler was at Herald, so your stop side. And then he was mid, so all the focus of your team is above, and you make a play on your own, which kills an army. But at this point, it's not really valuable to kill an army if you have such a big shutdown. Okay, so Ash gets 700 gold extra, which is a huge swing. But now, so she was 1700 gold behind and now only 1000. Even less with the plates. So, do they get this though? Yeah. You try everything to defend it, but the next wave is coming. So if you place Herald mid, that would be the first turret. And then this wouldn't really be a problem. But now this is the first turret, which gives a huge gold swing to them. Okay, this is after Lucian died. I need to pick up the exact moment between. So right now you are 2000 gold ahead. And turret would make you 3000 gold ahead if nothing happens here. 3000 gold ahead plus infernal, plus towers open mid lane. Instead, you're 700 gold. In front. So you're still in front, but you are 2,200 gold less in front because you didn't place the herald and you're going for play on your own without vision information, etc. Two tiny mistakes that cost like 1,000 gold each. So I just want to make you aware of how much that will cost. So the wave clears are matchable, so for you it's just, yeah. You can kill the wave quite fast and he just stands alone. He, anytime he walks back, you need to ping it, and yeah, like you do here, and they need to, Angelina's need to be aware. You do know the, so with Talon, he can walk around and jump this wall, so you're never safe. You roam again. It's Giovanni. Nice. Nice. So this is a play that I think shouldn't have worked, but it worked out because of mechanics. It just kind of... what is it? It's unexpected. But he... You have a ward here, and he has a ward here. So he plays topside. And if he is here, you can't walk on him, because if you... If you walk on him, he can walk back. This is Giovanni ult is still down, if this is correct. Okay. So Giovanni ult, I think, is should be down. Then you just can't do this. You know the other times he pushes the wave and he walks to here. So wait until he's here. He won't walk up to here, because he's smarter than that. But he will walk up to here. And that's the better moment to walk in. But this is smurfing. Doesn't matter that you die, you're just a trash. And then you even kill the Camille, because Camille tried to help Talon instead of doing a red. Bam. Ash will punish you, bro. The turret is not worth it, bro. You're on your own, in a lane, and then you don't make plays. You will get the third. This is not the first third, so you lose the bonus there. It's after 40 minutes, so there's no playthings. So there's no reason to go for the third right now. The herald is down, so that's also not a reason. And even Infernal is up. Infernal is up means you want to have your bot lane stay bot and not swap. So the like every thing you think about makes you want to stay alive in bot lane. Instead, you create for third and die, which gives them more gold than it gives you, and even gives them tempo, the wave, etc., etc. If your trash roams and he communicates, okay, going mid for the play, which worked out with 2 kills and pressure, then you just okay, I'm gonna sit in lane, push the wave, and back off. Maybe get wards in here. You still have the pink ward that you bought earlier. If you push, just put the pink here. In this bush. And again, action top lane this time. Teemo is low. Should be a free kill. So what does he do? You walk up to him way too much. And you get aggro from turret, right? Yeah. So let's see. You got 58 armor. Sejuani gets 141. If she sees, okay, only 145. Turret. If turret hits you, it does damage. If turret hits Sejuani, it does jack shit. So if Sejuani is coming for the dive, just let the Sejuani kill the team. Or start the aggro. Bam, bam. You just wait. Just do nothing. Stand here. And only when the Sejuani is here, then you move up. And then you don't even need to hit the ultimate. Sejuani can E, Q, and W. And if your flamesweller and E just hit, then he's dead. And then it causes your flash and it makes you die, which is unlucky. And unnecessary. Please help, bro! I can't ping it, feels bad. Please help. Mid lane was the best opportunity, but this is still an opportunity to get a turret. And it's getting really close to expiring. Which would be a shame if you just do it on nothing. Oh my god, again, a kill. It's a bloody game. You have no vision on them. You know Infernal is up. You can ward Infernal over this wall. But walking here is dangerous since your jungler is, again, jungler is topside. So your topside is stronger. And getting this vision is good if you can it, but it's kind of luxury. If you ward the dragon to here, then you know, okay, they're on dragon or they're not. And this vision here makes you know, okay, when they walk here. Getting this is kind of a luxury. And not needed. Like, Ahri is safe when she's ult, if she backs off here and waits for ultimate, she's safe. And so this is a dangerous play, and you get punished. What the fuck was the W? Okay. Sorry, I shouldn't flame. Bam! Okay, but this is too dangerous right now. They place what here is good. But your focus should be Infernal after now. Which is kind of clunky because you have Herald up. You can't really do a Dragon Dance. Yeah, you should give this up. Yeah, you can go for steel, but... Wait, was your smile cool then? No, it wasn't. It does 640. You have vision on it. That's early. Just bad. 15. Oh! I think this was the play you talked about on WhatsApp. Where Akam jumped in, where you jumped in, Akam teleported. Okay, this is devastating. Unlucky you didn't get the dragon with the steel. But it shouldn't come down to this. If the jungler just plays his herald top, pushes the wave and then walks bot, the support walks here and walks over this. Over the wall. And then the AD carry comes, the support comes, the jungler could be on his way. Mid lane could also be there. If you call her, and then you still have TP in case they contest it. But then you're at least 4 men strong, which is stronger than their 4 men, with the TP advantage since Teemo has Ignite. And then this would be really clean and you get the dragon every time. Instead, this is a really good, really gold swing, which makes the gold to be even. With a little bit cleaner macro, you could have just been ahead by 6 or 7,000 gold by now, and the game would be over. Oh no, please don't let me have it will expire. And it's gone. I love the confidence, man. So, right now you need to assess, okay, we just gave them a dragon which makes them equal, they're kind of equal in kills. What do we do? What do we do here? Well, there are no neutral objectives, they are both down. Baron will come up, but it will take a time. Bot tier 1 turret is down, mid is up, top is up. You can choose, you don't have TP, but Rumble is stronger than Teemo, I think, still. This is a point where Sejuani is also useful, since she's kind of strong. She's really useful wherever she goes. Medlin is even a level up, but it's really good that you, yeah, you still only died once, so after level 3, I think you played really well. with not dying and trying to get CS because your CS is equal now. But I still don't think you can find a one-on-one, but holding mid lane is still possible for you. And bot lane is stronger. But even that is kind of zone. I think I'd put bot lane top. To get the tower really quickly with the jungler parting around here. Try to kill Teemo, get in the tower fast, and then the you can join mid with the rest. Just get the top tower for some gold. Instead you go mid, it's also fine, but no one is top lane. Again, now you go. Yeah, okay, so you do that. You put the rumble bot and the bot lane top. Okay, you think you can kill them on your own? This is... Okay, so you know everything here, but you don't know where Camille is. He's half AP and you ult straight into him. I think you can hit a Q first. To poke him even lower, force him out of lane. So he's kind of in a tough spot. Okay, this forces his ult, forces him back, that's good. And he walks through his jungle. Why? Because maybe Camille is there, you don't know. But you chase him. And you flash into Camille, that's unlucky. You still have an ult left. And now, okay, so you won here. Why? Because you run to your jungler. For help. So if you hit Talon, why does he walk here? Because he also has a jungler. So you ulting him here and making him force back was good because it forced him out of lane. Then you get that mid turret with Tsihi. But going farther into this jungle is dangerous. You barely live. No. Okay, so this forces them both back. So that's good. And then the mid lane with the bot lane with the jungler can get the start. Wait, Rumble also died? Oh shit. This turret is down. You are here to defend this turret. You are not here to defend these patches of grass. And Ashe has an ultimate ability that stuns you. Nami has a wave that knocks you up. And then has a bubble. Every auto that she does slows you. They have a lot of CC in this lane. And you can just stay here to give this up. Instead, you try to contest. Bam, bada bing, bada boom. And you die, and they get the turret. That's unlucky. You can stay here to defend the turret. With Flame Spitter, make the turret go down quite slowly. Instead of just dying and giving up the turret in one wave. Ash, please. Okay, Ash misses like fucking fuck ton of CS. And you get mid turret, it's good. Good rotation by Bob. And you get half the turret, but they get the whole. Now reaching. They made the desperation play to just go on you with the two assassins without reaching in back. Don't know why. This seems uncoordinated. Oh, let's kill them. Let's kill them here. Let's kill them there, etc. And I think you can agree with me on that one. That it is just randomly walking and killing. Okay, so Talon should not be able to assassinate if you're close, if the Lucius is close to Sejuani and Aris is close to Sejuani. So it's good that they group up mid. And Bumble can try to push waves and wait for his TP to be up. Should be like 1.5 to 2 minutes or something. Ocean is used as well. I mean, it's good that you kill them, but it's not really a lot to say. It's only thing is that they get a turret. Even though you get kills, they almost get a turret. You should die, right? Oh, yes, all turret. But you get an ocean drake at 21 minutes while you're not playing a siege comp or something. So the ocean is not valuable. Lantern? Oh, not needed. Okay, nice visual needed. Pippin! Oh, it's Ash Arrow? Ah, unlucky. Now I'm gonna watch it. I'm loving the Star Guardian silence. Ah, so you're terrified. Yeah. You get a ward here, so you know who's coming. You don't have a ward here, that's unlucky. But you know that's only Camille and Talon. So you can turn on them. Even though Sejuani doesn't have a... You have Thresh ult to slow them and Akam to place assault over them, like he does here. Yeah. So this turn is good, but I think Thresh didn't need to die there. Now Camille is down. Skuller is good. You can take this for HP. Do you have Vormox already? No. Now you can do Baron. Like, what are they gonna do? It's just Ashe and Nami. Ashe doesn't have ultimate. And it's a Teemo. Nah. I don't think it's that risky to try Baron because Ahri is coming way earlier than they are. I just saw you do a lot of damage on it. So you start Baron when the jungler is up and close. And when the jungler is dead, you don't start it. I kind of wonder why. Wait, do you get engaged then? If you stand close to Sejuani, you probably won't die. There's no Sejuani here. And you don't know where people are. You just see an Ashe. And trust me, this Ashe is not standing here alone. Nami ult, you still go on. Double hits. And you die. Like, I mentioned that it doesn't matter how far behind Ahri is because he still has a charm and can be a charm bot. It's also the case for Ashe. It doesn't matter how far behind she is, she always has her ultimate. And now you die because Sejuani isn't there. Just wait for her. Just get, I don't know, wolves or something. Or just literally stand here still until the support and Sejuani are here. A lot of over-aggressive plays which aren't really thought about. It's just, oh, we see an enemy, so we go in, and that's dangerous. It's really dangerous to do. You lose a lot of it, and now you're even behind in gold. Again, this is random fighting. You don't want You don't need any vision here. You know if they are bot or if they are mad. If you don't have the priority, you can't walk into them. But, like, Ash shouldn't be here. It's good that you kill her, but this is Ash's fault. This is Camille's fault. Chief. Unlucky TP. You could TP here. You could have TP'd here and late the ultimate and stall. Do you have Sonya? Oh, you don't have Sonya, but you have stoppage. So you could have TP'd behind him, killed him. Let's see when. Here, when Ash is dead, you know your TP makes it a 3v3. So you TP here or here. This is of course better in hindsight, but either one of them is good. And if you would have TP'd here, you can lay the ultimate here and then those two die and you get Baron. This is just a missed opportunity, but it's fine. Pushing mid is good, but again you're on your own. And so you are close to Sejuani, so you don't die. Because Sigi is the ultimate carrier for us. Bam! Oh? Fucking Teemo, man. But you still get third, which is fine. You almost kill Ash. And now you need to reset. It's an Infernal coming up, which is a lot better than Ocean. And you walk in alone. So Sejuani can do this to get vision, because he's incredibly tanky. But you just need to back off, bro. Ash is solo pushing, so it's a good call to go in and kill them all. Oh, that juicy Rumble ultimate. So what do you know now?
You got a lot of kills.
You have an Ash pushing here. Sejuani, do you have Warmogs already? No. Can you do Baron? I think Sejuani is too low. Then Akam needs to tank it, then no one is back for Ash. But someone needs to back for Ash. Turns out Rumble does it, yeah. If she doesn't get in it, she does. Wait, just int for the in it. Oh well. Okay, she's going to do it. Okay, she should have just inted for in it. But you kill her, that's nice. Baron is set up, they don't have any carry. The getting this vision is really good. You can kill this plant just so they can't use it. Nice. And now you just start the Baron and turn on them. Aoi is coming. Oh, you can sit in. Okay. Why can't I ping SS? That's bad. Yeah, felt himself there. SS and players. So Sejuani, your tank, just audio. You only got 1,000 gold, there's no really reason to back. If you back, they can Baron. But instead they go in, so you turn on them. Like, if they went in, like, 2 seconds later. Yeah, okay, like, 6 seconds later. You would have backed. And then you would have died. Because then Ash is also closer. And Nami can ult. This is really dangerous to stay here when Sejuani is back. The call should be to engage, because you know Talon jumped a lot of walls and is still back. And Rumble could have joined. Or you call Rumble to not go top, but to fight as a team since Talon is down without ultimate. Or you say, okay, we back, we stall, you can push until the turret, but don't hit the turret, because it's overextending. But now it's Rumble wants to push, Sejuani wants to back, Ahri wants to contest the wave, and Joost probably wants to fight if it looks like the rest of the game. And this is kind of fiesting. Why? You should be dead. Ah, Talon doesn't have the boss. Move with your team. S5 sec. There's nothing to gain here. This is all empty. Well, this is the objective. So you get top tower, and now if you walk here, you are 5 men strong. Pushing this wave is fine, and then Wolf move to the Baron or hard engage. But you can put a trigger here. You can call a com. Since you know the Camille is back. So there are windows where you can stop the AWAM to force something, especially with that comp, like bam, pull the trigger. Nice hook. See, you win this super hard. It's good that you take the fight to win this. But here the Sejuani, they engage on Teemo, like with the Rens like the initial, yeah, the initiation. You can do the Sejuani really easily. The W, the slow is kind of enough, the Q and the ultimate are skill shots, but they're super wide just to get them at least slowed. And like you do here the Q, but you don't need to move back, your team is coming, you're really tanky, your armor and magic resist are insane. And instead you kind of back off, nothing happens, but because the trash lands this amazing hook, and she's inting, but because Trash Lens is amazing hook, that's the trigger. And I feel like Sigi, Sejuani, you can pull the trigger. And then Trash is there for the follow-up engage. If you used to see someone, then Trash can flash hook something. Because the hook is kind of a slow ability and the skill shot. I think it's better that Sejuani pulls the trigger and Trash just follows up as in. Instead, the hook is really good, and this, then the Sejuani is there for the follow-up, and this makes you kill them, and that's good. Now you can end. Is she going to end? Whoa, what the? Nice. Oh, he looked really strange there. And then he dies, and then you win. So out of this game, it's if the jungler is top or bot side, that side is stronger, so that side can try to make plays and be careful of getting punished cross map, like Joost did a couple of times, and Akam did later on at the third. Where the jungler is really matters a lot. Also knowing where the Camille is. Overextensions are dangerous. If the enemy are coming back up, it's dangerous. And try to avoid the all around the mid. Pushing up the wave is fine, then contesting the vision. Then contesting the vision here, and then contesting the vision here. You have the stronger team fighting comp. With Sejuani, she can pull the trigger, and the rest can follow up. And the Lucian and the Ahri just hit what's in front of them since they shred them. Like the hitting tanks first, and tanks in this case is Camille, like they don't really have tank, but hitting what's in front so they stay safe themselves. The carries stay close to Sejuani, and they are missed opportunities early with, for example, Harold. If the getting a lot of plays with Harold is really good because of the gold swing, and you don't risk losing first tower anywhere else. Bam. But overall, GG. Good early plays. You too. here, but then you manage to kill them because your comp is stronger.